Hello friends, let's understand the reasons for growth of derivative products and markets. What has caused the tremendous growth in the derivatives market as we see in last about 2 to 3 decades? Is it only attributable to speculation? Why is there so much of innovation taking place in the derivative products all the time? And most importantly, will the derivatives market continue to grow in future as well? The recorded history of use of derivatives products dates back to almost 12th century in Europe, where the wool used to be sold in the forward contracts by the wool merchants. In Japan, we have instances of rice being sold in the forward contracts way back in 17th century. In USA and India also, we have records of forward contracts in various commodities, including gold, silver, almost 150 to 200 years back. Today, there's a huge market for derivative products and services. Why so? Let's look at the reasons. The number one reason is the increased fluctuation in the prices of the underlying assets. The derivatives are designed to protect you from the fluctuation in the prices of the underlying assets. For example, food products like wheat, rice, something like cotton, groundnut seeds, or oil, metals, so on and so forth. In the last century, we have seen a lot of fluctuation in the prices of these various commodities because of number of reasons like wars, social unrest, changes in weather, new usage of these products and market, and so on and so forth. Hence, there is an increased appetite of derivatives on these commodities and products to protect against the risk of fluctuation in the prices. The second important reason has been integration of global financial markets. The trade across the globe has been existing for over 1,000 years. However, post the Second World War, there has been a lot of emphasis on internationalization of various markets. Recently, the bodies like World Trade Organization and through General Agreement on Trade and Tariff, GATT, lot of internationalization has been pushed through. Because of this, a demand for commodities, resources, skills across the globe. For example, there is a huge demand for copper, zinc, oil, and many commodities across the globe. So we have to also now protect from the risk of changes in the prices of those commodities and also changes in the currency prices. So that has led to the increased demand for derivative products to protect against those fluctuations. The third important reason is the advancement of information, communication, and technology, or ICT. Because of the information, communication, and technology revolution, the impact has been there on the derivatives and other markets across the entire value chain. It is very easy to research the derivative products, create the products, manage risk, sell the products, trade the products, clear and settle the products. So there is an impact across the entire value chain. The transaction costs have come down tremendously because of IT, and larger volumes are possible because of arbitrage. Arbitrage is basically a situation where traders try to exploit differences in the products prices across different markets or at different points in time. This has created higher liquidity, and therefore the derivative markets have been growing. Fourth important reason is that more financing options have become available. With the easy money policy followed by various central banks in last 2 to 3 decades, which got reversed only in 2022, there have been a lot of finances available for various assets including derivative products. In India, for example, the increased inflow of FII funds, the availability of funds from, let's say, family offices, the availability of funds with large investment banks and banks has ensured that the derivative products in Forex, futures on indices, options on indices, and on various stocks are thriving. There are hedge funds, for example, which are a relatively new phenomenon in India, but they have been there for almost 4 to 5 decades in US. So they are also risk takers who use derivative products in a big way. The fifth important reason is the sophisticated risk management tools that have come up in the recent past. More and more professionals have got attracted to financial markets and derivatives market, like chartered accountants, MBAs, chartered financial analysts, financial risk managers, and so on and so forth. A lot of people have invested in the IT technology. The new technology firms have come up which specialize in creating risk management products for the derivatives. Big data and analytics is being used, and AI ML models are being used now, leveraged in a very big way to manage the risk. All this has led to the sophisticated risk management, which has created confidence in the mind of the investors that they can take position in the derivatives market. The sixth reason is frequent innovation in the derivative products and services. Newer and newer derivative products have come up, they are catering to different kind of hedging requirements. The speculators and arbitrageurs are using it for various purposes. For example, credit default swaps, which are fundamentally meant for hedging against the risk of default in, let's say, bonds, are being widely used by the speculators. In fact, GFC 2008 or global financial crisis was caused primarily because MBS, ABS, CDS, CDO, the hedging products were widely being used for speculation. And the newer products are coming up which are catering to the demand for derivatives. For example, USD derivatives have been on the rise in the last 3-4 decades because USD has come up as a global reserve currency. Seventh reason, newer application of the derivative products has come up. Derivatives started mainly as forwards way back in commodities trading. Then slowly bonds came up, equities derivatives came up, indices derivatives came up, interest rate derivatives came up, and currency derivatives became big. And newer derivative products like on freight indices, weather derivatives or carbon derivatives, and recently cryptocurrency derivatives like, for example, futures and options on Bitcoin. So newer and newer application of derivative products have come up. Eighth reason is higher liquidity in the markets that has led to bigger growth of the market. The speculators, arbitragers, traders in the market create a lot of liquidity in the market. And therefore, the people who are genuine hedgers, who actually look at derivatives as a hedging product, they are confident that they can exit their positions if required. So liquidity is self-perpetuating. In the sense, if the markets are liquid, more and more people take the risk because they know they can exit their positions at any given point in time. This required a robust clearing and settlement mechanism, which has also been made available. So higher and higher liquidities in the derivative market has led to increased volume of the derivative products. Ninth reason is the enhanced risk appetite of investors. Newer investors have come to market like hedge funds, family offices, other alternative investment funds. Even retail investors are taking risk in the derivatives market. I know of my students who trade in the derivatives market, futures and options on National Stock Exchange. The investors traditionally look for safe returns, like, for example, endowment funds, pension funds. They also diversified and started putting some part of their money in derivatives market to make sure that they earn higher returns, because the traditional products have been continuing to give lower returns as compared to, let's say, derivative products. There's an increased regulatory oversight and market mechanism. For example, Bank for International Settlements, the global banking oversight body, has laid down various norms for capital adequacy and have put a burden on the central banks to comply with a lot of standards that they set up. The self-regulated organizations have come up in a big way, like exchanges. In India, for example, we have Financial Benchmarks India Limited, which publishes the rates on which derivative contracts are built. The OTC trades are being handled by using ISD or ISDA, the International Swaps and Derivatives Association templates and rules, so that they also facilitate the growth in the derivatives market. The improved trading and settlement mechanism, for example, trading on BSE, NSE, settlement through DTCC in US or CCIL, Clearing Corporation of India in India, for example, has made sure that the market is more and more confident of entering into derivative contracts. The 11th reason is increased awareness of derivative segment. The awareness has increased because of higher education. As I said, more and more professionals have gone into market, like chartered accountants, MBAs, CFAs, and financial risk managers. Mainstream media has also been educating people on the derivatives, TV, newspapers. And then there are other participants in the market, like regulators themselves, the exchanges, brokers. They have been also creating a lot of awareness of the derivative products. Knowing this will help you identify future trends in the derivatives market and also identify better career opportunities for you. I hope you found this video useful. If yes, please do like this video and also share this video with your friends who will benefit from this. Also, don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Thank you very much. Cheers.